Good morning students, this is Madhu again. Today we are going to discuss about prism, what is meant by prism and how the refraction is occurred on the prism and derivation of the refractive index of the prism. So what is meant by prism? Prism is a transparent medium. Prism is a transparent medium which is separated from the surrounding medium by at least two plane surfaces which are inclined at a certain angle. So prism is a transparent medium when compared to the surrounding medium and covered by two plane surfaces which are inclined at a certain angle. So this is called prism. So here we are taking one triangular prism. It has two triangular bases and three rectangular lateral surfaces. If any light ray which comes from any light source incident on any one of the lateral surface of the prism, those light ray emerges another lateral surface of those prism. So prism is a transparent medium separated from the surrounding medium by at least two plane surfaces which are inclined at a certain angle. So here this is the structure of the prism like this. So this is the triangular prism. This one and this one are triangular bases. This one and other side of the prism and bottom side of the prism has a triangular surfaces. This is the rectangular surfaces. These two are the triangular surfaces. For example, any light ray, if you place any triangular prism on its triangular base on any surface and draw the shape of those prism along its edges, then we get one triangular. Okay, then the vertices ABC or PQR like this. Select any one point on side PQ and name those point as a M. Draw one perpendicular to PQ at M, then we get this is the perpendicular. Perpendicular means the angle between this line and side PQ is 90 degrees. Draw one more line which makes certain angle with normal. So this angle is treated as the angle between this ray and normal is treated as an incident angle. Incident angle. So again, recall the refraction principles. Any light ray which passes from rarer medium to denser medium, the corresponding refracted ray moves nearer to the normal. So its original direction is like this. It moves nearer to the normal so that it bends like this. It bends like this. And again, each incident one more point on the another surface of the prism, this point is treated as a N. This point is treated as a N. Draw one normal to the side PR at N. We get here The original direction of this refracted ray is like this. According to the principles of refraction, any light ray which passes from denser to rarer, the corresponding refracted ray moves away to the normal, so that this zone is nearer to the normal, so it moves like this, moves away to the normal. So this point is treated as a N. So any light ray which incident on any one lateral surface of the prism, those light ray passes again, it gets one more refraction on another lateral surface of those prism and moves like this. So this is the behavior of the any light ray which incident on one lateral surface of the prism. Here the angle between this first incident ray and a normal is called incident angle, which is denoted by the letter I1. Here also this is called refracted ray. So the angle between refracted ray and normal is called refraction angle or refraction angle R1. Here also we get this light ray gets one more refraction. Here also two angles are formed. The angle between this ray, here this light ray again gets one more refraction and emerges outside, so that the angle between normal and emerging ray is called emerging angle or angle of emergence, which is denoted by the letter I2. Here the angle between this ray and the normal is called refraction angle R2. Here and also one more angle is formed at vertices P. One angle is there. This angle is called angle of prism. Angle of prism. So here we have so many angles where any light ray which incidents on one lateral surface of the prism, it gets one refraction at one lateral surface, again it gets one more refraction on another lateral surface of those prism. At that time we have this angle is called angle of incidence, this angle is called angle of refraction at first refraction, this angle is called angle of emergence when the light ray gets a second refraction and emerges from the another lateral surface of the prism. This angle is called angle of refraction when light ray gets a second refraction, and this angle is called angle of prism. So now we are going to discuss how to find the refractive index of the prism. The prism. This is one lab activity. To do this activity, we require one prism and some iron pins and one cardboard and one drawing sheet. So take one prism, place on the cardboard which is covered with a white drawing sheet. Take one prism and place the cardboard on its triangular base. Name the vertices of those prism P, Q, R, like this. Okay. Say, take any one point on the side PQ, name those point as M. Draw one normal to PQ at M. Draw one more line which makes some angle with normal. Those angle is called angle of incidence or denoted by the letter I1. According to the principles of refraction, any light ray which moves from rarer to denser, the corresponding refracted ray, the original direction of the original direction is like this, but it moves nearer to the normal, so that it moves like this. And again, it incident on the another lateral surface of the prism. So those point is treated as a N. Draw one normal to PR at N. So again, recall the principles of refraction. Any light ray which moves from denser tube to the corresponding refracted ray moves away to the normal. So it moves like this. So here this is called angle of incidence I1. This is called angle of refraction at first refraction. This is refracted ray and this is normal. So R1. So the angle between this is called emerging ray. The angle between emerging ray and the normal is called I2. And also the angle between refracted ray and this normal is called R2. So at top vertex of the prism, this angle is called angle of prism. This is denoted by the letter F. Okay, if you extend the original paths of incident ray and emerging ray, those two rays intersect at one point, those point is treated as O. Here also one angle is formed between incident ray and emerging ray. Those angle is called angle of deviation. Angle of deviation. Which is denoted by the letter D. So this is the arrangement for the lab activity in which we are going to find the refractive index of the prism. So first we are taking one triangular prism. It has two triangular bases and three rectangular lateral surfaces. First we take one cardboard which is covered by the white drawing sheet and place the prism on its triangular base and draw the shape of the prism along its edges. At that time we get one triangle. Okay, so select one point on one side and draw one normal to that point and draw one more line which makes some angle with those normal. Those angle is called angle of incidence. And write a tabular column, serial number, angle of incidence, angle of emergence, angle of deviation. Okay, so first we place any two pins on this incident ray. Observe the images of these two pins from the other side of the prism and place two more pins in such a manner the images of these two pins and newly arranged pins are lying in the same straight line. Identify all those points and draw along those points, draw a line along those points, we get emerging there. So we do this activity for so many angles, angle 30, angle 40, angle 50, angle 60, like this. And for every angle of incidence, we get one angle of emergence and angle of deviation. Where we get angle of deviation? If we extend incident ray and emerging ray in the same direction, at that time, those two rays intersect at point O, that one angle is formed between these two lines, those angle is called angle of deviation. Okay? So, by using these values, we draw one graph on this graph. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. On x-axis we are plotting angle of incidence. On y-axis we are plotting the values of angle of deviation. Angle of deviation. So by using these values, if we draw one graph, we get one smart curve like this. One smart curve like this. Okay. So from the bottom of the curve, we draw one parallel line to the x-axis. It intersects at one point on the y-axis. Those value is called minimum angle of deviation. Minimum angle of deviation. This is denoted by the letter capital D. From the bottom of the curve, we draw one more line which is parallel to the y-axis, which intersects at one point on the x-axis. Those angle is called angle of incidence. So if we do this activity at this angle of incidence, we get one observation, that is at minimum angle of deviation, at minimum angle of deviation, angle of incidence is equals to the angle of emergence. Angle of incidence is equals to the angle of emergence. So at minimum angle of deviation, at minimum angle of deviation, angle of incidence, which is equals to the angle of emergence when one light ray incidents on any one lateral surface of the triangular prism. So by substituting these values in the refractive index formula, we get the refractive index of the prism. Next, we are going to derive the refractive index of the prism. Refractive index of the prism. So mathematical derivation for refractive index of the prism. So here observe this OMN triangle. Here this side is extended at the time an exterior angle is formed. So according to properties of the triangle, exterior angle is equals to the opposite interior angle. So in triangle OMN, exterior angle D is equals to opposite interior angles. So what is this value? What is the value of this angle? According to mathematics, opposite angles at any vertex is equals to are equal. Opposite angles at any vertex. So this is I1, this is also I1, but this is R1, this is I1, this is R1. At that time, this is I1 minus R1. I1 minus R1 plus this is also I2 minus R2. D is equals to I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2. D is equals to I1 plus I2 minus R1 minus R2. D is equals to I1 plus I2 minus, taken as a common factor, then R1 plus R2. Minus into plus minus R1, minus into plus minus R2. This is treated as a equation 1. Next, consider triangle PMN. The sum of the interior angles of any triangle is equals to 180 degrees. So angle A plus this angle, how much? From this point to this point 90 degrees. But this is R1. So from this point is 90 minus R1. 90 minus R1. In the same manner, this is normal. So here also PN side. From this point 90, but this is R2, then the value of this angle becomes to 90 minus R2 is equals to 190 degrees. Angle here, angle of prism plus 90 minus R1 plus 90 minus R2 is equals to 180 degrees. A plus 90 plus 90, 180 minus R1 minus R2 is equals to 180. 180, 180 is cancelled. A minus, minus taken as a common factor, R1 plus R2 is equals to 0. A, if any subtracting factor moves other side of the equality, it gets addition, A is equals to R1 plus R2. This is treated as a equation 2. So substitute A is equals to R1 plus R2 in the equation 1, then we get D is equals to I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2 is equals to A. So it moves other side of the equation, it gets D plus A is equals to I1 plus I2. It can be written as A plus D is equals to I1 plus I2. This is treated as a equation 3. Okay. So now here this is incident ray, this is emerging ray. So when any light ray incident on one lateral surface of any triangular prism, it gets first refraction on the first lateral surface, again it gets second refraction on the second lateral surface, so that the behavior of this light ray is like this. Now we are going to apply Snell's law at point M and at point N. What is meant by Snell's law? According to Snell's law, we can explain the behavior of the refraction ray, any light ray which passes one transparent medium to another transparent medium. So now we are applying Snell's law at point M and at point N. Okay. Snell's law. Applying Snell's law at point M. What is the Snell's law? N1 into sin I is equals to N2 into sin I. So at point M, N1, the refractive index of the surrounding medium. So where we are placed the prism, in any laboratory or in any classroom. So the surrounding medium of the prism is A. So N1 is equals to 1. Refractive index of the A is equals to 1. Angle of incidence, I is equals to I1. Angle of refraction, R is equals to R1. Refractive second medium, refractive index of the prism, N2 is equals to N. Substituting all these values in the Snell's law, then we get N1. So N1 is equals to 1. 1 into sin I1. N2 is equals to how much? N into sin R. So this is treated as a equation 4. Next we are going to apply Snell's law at N, point N. So here the first medium is prism, so denser medium. Second medium is A, that is rarer medium. So N1 becomes N, N2 becomes 1. So here this angle becomes to incident angle, I is equals to R2. This angle becomes to refraction angle, R is equals to I2. Substitute all these values in the Snell's law, we get N1, N into sine R2 is equals to N2 into sine R, R is equals to how much? I2. Here N2 is what? N2 is A, so 1. So sine I2. N into sin R2 is equals to sin I2. This equation is treated as a 5. So in the previous lab activity, we have already discussed at minimum angle of deviation. So minimum angle of deviation is denoted by the letter capital D. At minimum angle of deviation, angle of incidence must be equals to the angle of emergence. So at minimum angle of deviation capital D, angle of incidence is equals to the angle of emergence. If we substitute this value in the equation 3, we get A plus D. So here, why we are writing capital D? Minimum angle of deviation. I1 plus I1 or I2 plus I2. So A plus D is equals to 2I1. A plus D is equals to 2 plus 2I1. A plus D is equals to 2I1. So at minimum angle of deviation, angle of incidence is equals to the angle of emergence. Angle of emergence. In the same manner, R1 must be equals to the R2D. When I1 is equals to the I2, it must be equals to R1 is equals to R2 also. So, at minimum angle of deviation, R1 is equals to R2. R1 is also equals to R2. R1 is also equals to R2. According to equation 2, what is the equation 2? R1 plus R2 is equals to A. R1 plus R2 is equals to A, or A is equals to R1 plus R2. If R1 is equals to R2, we substitute in the place of R2 by R1, then we get R1 plus R1 is equals to A, or 2R1 is equals to A, or A is equals to 2R1. A is equals to 2R1. Substitute these two values. A plus D is equals to 2I1. A is equals to 2R1. In the equation 4, sin I1 is equals to N into sin R1. Here we are finding I1 and R1, so that we are substituting I1 value and R1 value in equation 4. If we find R2 and I2 values, then we can substitute those values in the equation 5. So here we are finding I1 and R1, so that we are substituting these values in the equation 4. Then we get sin I1 from this A plus D by 2 is equals to I1 A by 2. So A by 2 is equals to R1. Substitute these two values in the equation 4, we get sin I1. How much I1? A plus D by 2. A plus d by 2 is equals to n into sine r1, how much a by 2. So in this derivation we are going to find the value of the refractive index of the prism, so that is n. Here these two, there is no symbol between these two factors, means these two are multiplying with each other. So any multiplying factor moves other side of the equality, it gets division. So sin a plus d by 2 by sin a by 2 is equals to n. It can be written as n is equals to sin a plus d by 2 by sin a by 2. So this is the algebraical expression for the refractive index of the triangular prism. So n is equals to sin a plus d by 2 by sin a by 2. Here n is the refractive index of the prism, a is the angle of prism, d is the minimum angle of deviation. If we know these two, three values, we can find the refractive index of any triangular prism by using this formula. N is equals to sin a plus d by 2 by sin a by 2. Okay. Here we have one problem. A light ray falls one of the faces of the prism at an angle of 40 degrees. So that it suffers angle of minimum deviation of 30 degrees. Then find the angle of prism and angle of refraction at the given surface. So first of all, what are the given factors and what we have to find? Here given is angle of incidence I1 is equals to 40 degrees and angle of minimum deviation capital D is equals to 30 degrees. We have to find angle of prism A and angle of refraction. So at minimum angle of deviation, we have already known that at minimum angle of deviation, angle of incidence is equals to the angle of emergence. So in the previous explanation we derived one mathematical expression in which we find that A at a minimum angle of deviation, A plus D is equals to I1 plus I2 means 2I1. So from this equation we substitute these values. A, how much we don't know. D, it is given 30 degrees. 2I1 is how much? 40. So A plus 30 is equals to 80. A is equals to 80 minus 30. A is equals to 50 degrees. So this is the angle of prism. So at minimum angle of deviation, we get one equation, A plus D is equals to 2I1. How can you say that A plus D is equals to 2I1? At minimum angle of deviation, angle of incidence must be equals to the angle of emergence. By using those principle, we can write A plus D is equals to 2I1. Okay. Next, when at minimum angle of deviation, I1 is equals to the I2, in the same manner R1 is equals to R2. So, we know that A is equals to R1 plus R2. But at minimum angle of deviation, R1 is equals to R2. So that R1 in the place of R2, we can substitute R1. A is equals to 2R1 is equals to A by 2. So we find just now A is equals to 50 degrees. So R1 is equals to 50 by 2. 225. So R1 is equals to 25 degrees. So here angle of refraction is equals to 25 degrees and angle of prism is equals to 50 degrees. Because here the angle of minimum deviation is given by the 30 degrees in the problem. So when the at angle of minimum deviation A plus D is equals to I1 plus I2 means 2I1, a plus d is equals to 2a1. In the same manner, a is equals to r1 plus r2. How can you write these two equations? In the previous class, we derived the mathematical derivation of the refractive index of the prism. At that time, we get these two equations, a plus d is equals to 2a1 and a is equals to r1 plus r2. By using these two equations, we get these two values. Here, we have to remind one important thing, that is, at minimum angle of deviation, angle of incidence must be equals to the angle of emergence. At capital D, I1 is equals to I2. Okay.